video, let us learn an important concept known as logarithm. Actually, logarithm is used for fast calculations of multiplication and divisions and all. Actually, how it is used for multiplication, division and everything is not in your syllabus, even though in the next class we will go through that also. Okay, so first of all, you should know what is a concept, what is logarithm, you should understand. How many 2's, let me ask you, how many 2's should be multiplied to get 8? Quite simple, you will say that 3 2's should be multiplied to get 8. But if I ask you, how many 3's should be multiplied to get 81? The answer is quite simple, right? So, how many 2's should be multiplied to get the number 8? We know that it is 2 into 2 into 2. That means 3 2's should be multiplied to get 8. Actually, in your earlier classes, you noted this one as 2 cube is equal to 8. We call it as the exponential form, right? Or otherwise, if I ask you, how many 3's should be multiplied to get 81? You know that 3 into 3 into 3. That means how many 3's? 4 3's should be multiplied to get 81. Right. So, as an exponential form, you will write it in the form of 3 power 4 is equal to 81. Right. No doubt in that. Because 3 power 4 means 3 should be multiplied 4 times to get 8. Actually, the same idea we can represent in another mode by using the technique logarithm. Okay, so how many 2's are multiplying? We are multiplying 3 2's to get which number? 8. So, log 8 is to get 8. How many 2's should be used? Should be multiplied. So the base is 2. How many 2's should be multiplied to get 8? The same concept we are writing in this way. Equal to how many 2's are needed? 3 2's are needed. So we call this one as log 8 to the base 2. So, just like exponential form, we are talking about a base. See here, 2 cube. 2 is a base, 3 is an exponent. The same way, here also there will be a base. When we are talking about a logarithm, it will never comes without a base. So, how many times this number should be multiplied to get this number? How many times? 3 times. So, we represent it as 3. So, in same fact, how can we write? To get 81, how many 3's should be multiplied? That means log 81, how many 3's should be multiplied? How many 3's should be multiplied? 4 3's should be multiplied. So we write it as 4. Right. So if I show you like this, log 625 to the base of 5. Okay. Can you say the meaning of this? Log 625 to the base of 5. That means how many times this number 5 should be multiplied to get 625. Okay. Once again, to get 625, how many times this base should be multiplied? Okay, that is the meaning of this one. We know that 5 should be multiplied how many times? 4 times, right? 5 into 5 into 5 into 5, that is equal to 625. So, we write that log 625 to the base of 5 is equal to 4. The same one, exponential form, how we will write? The same fact we can write it as 5 power 4 is equal to 625. Okay, this is a concept of law. So, in general, we can say that if A power x is equal to n, if A power x is equal to n, we can write it in the logarithmic form like how many times A should be multiplied to get n. That is this power mean. That is why we write this one as log n. The same factor is this one. Log n to the base A is equal to s. Okay. Log n to the base A. Here in the exponential, but don't forget this one. The exponential form, which base we are using. In the logarithmic form also, we will use the same base. No difference at all. So, what is the meaning of this one? To get the number n, how many times A should be multiplied? How many times should be multiplied? X number, X times should be multiplied. So, here there are conditions. A should be greater than 0 always. And it should not be equal to 1. So, A should be greater than 0 and A should not be 1 at all. Okay, understand? So, once again, this is a general condition, logarithmic form general condition. So, hope you have understood. Once again, I will tell you 2 into 2 into 2. That means 3 2s are multiplied to get the number 8. That is why we are writing that log 8 to get to 8. Which number is multiplying? 2 is multiplying. That is why we are writing 2 as the base. How many times we are multiplying? That is the answer. 3 times are multiplying. That is why 3 is the answer. Okay. So, actually, by understanding the logarithmic concept, we can go for fast multiplication and division. Okay. That also we will learn, even though it is not needed for you as a part of the theory. In the due this part of your textbook, there are simple questions like asked like this. Write the powers to which the bases to be raised. Already we discussed with the topic. 64 is equal to 2 power raise. Means what be the power to get 64? To which power 2 should be raised to get 64? 2 should be multiplied 6 times to get 64. That's why we can write this one as 64 is equal to, this implies 64 is equal to 2 power 6. That means x is equal to 6. Right. Okay, in this one let us see 1 by 81 is equal to 3 power 5. We know that 81 is equal to 3 power 4. Right. Then what is 1 by 81? 1 by 81 is equal to 1 by 3 power 4. Or otherwise, we can write in this format also 3 power minus 4. Because 1 by a power m is equal to a power minus m. Already in the exponential notation, the earlier classes you have studied that one. So, 1 by 81 is equal to 3 power minus 4. So, 1 by 81 can be written as 3 power minus 4. So, what is y? Y is equal to minus 4. Okay, right? Okay, there is one more question from the, try this part of your textbook. Write the following relation in exponential form and find the values of corresponding variables. Okay, we have to write the given fact in the exponential notation. Already I told you, log 10,000 to the base 10 means to get 10,000, the number 10, how many times it should be multiplied? So, 10, how many times by multiplying we will get 10,000? We know that 4 times by multiplying, 10 into 10 into 10 into 10, we will get 10,000. So, we can write this fact as 10 power 4 is equal to 10,000. Right? So, what is our result? What is our variable? 4 is a variable. because we multiplied it 10 four times. 10 into 10 into 10 into 10. Four times we multiplied it 10. Then only we got 10,000. So our variable is 4. So Z is 4. Right? Okay. Now there is another question here. Log is 1 by 343 to the base 7 is equal to minus 8. That means we want to find out what is 8 here. We know that 343 is equal to 7 cube. Right? So, to get 1 by 343, to get 343, 7 should be raised 3 times. So to get 1 by 343 from the rule of a power minus m is equal to 1 by a power m, we can clearly understand that 1 by 343 is equal to 7 power minus 3. So the exponential notation of this is this one. Okay, that means what is our a? Minus a is equal to minus 3 or a is equal to 3. So minus a equal to minus 3 or a is equal to 3. Correct? Okay, from the think and discuss part, there is one more question. You know that 2 power 1 is equal to 2. Alright, 2 power 1 is equal to 2. Like that any power, power 1 equal to 4. 4 power 1 is equal to 4. 8 power 1 is equal to 8 and 10 power 1 is equal to 10. What do you notice about the values of log 2 to the base 2? This one, log 2 to the base 2 or other ways, log 4 to the base 4 and so on. Okay. What can you generalize from this? Okay, same here. According to the concept what we have understood, we know that to get the number 2, how many times 2 should be multiplied? Or otherwise, to get the number 4, how many times 4 should be multiplied? From everywhere we know that to get the same number, we have to multiply it only one time. So log 2 to the base 2 is how many times we are multiplying? One time we are multiplying. That is why in the exponential form, how we will write it as 2 power 1 is equal to 2. Or otherwise, we will write this one as 4 power 1 is equal to 4. That only this one. Okay. So from this, what did you understand? Log 2 to the base 2 or log 4 to the base 4, log 8 to the base 8 or log 8 to the base a, in general everything becoming 1. Okay, if the number and the base is same, we will get the answer as 1. Okay, it's an important concept in that one. Log a to the base a is equal to 1. If it is log 100 to the base 100, that also is equal to 1.